people, welcome to this video. I'm going to explain you how to render 2D graphic designs. If you find mistakes in voice pronunciation, correct us in comments. First of all, we will work always with the dynamic input on. Make sure it is enabled here at the bottom, and so in light blue color. Very important in 2D drawings is the polyline. This is pretty different from the line, since it puts together lines and arcs. Let's see it better. When you draw lines to create a polygon, they do stay defined separately, so that when you click on one of them, the selection acts just on one line and not on the whole polygon. Different is the polyline. When you create the same polygon with a polyline, the selection is made on the whole polygon, because composed by one single polyline object. Click on the polyline to start editing it. It will have squared points and small rectangles on each side that you can use to edit your polyline properly. Hold Shift down to select more than one single point to keep constant the sides that are between such points while editing. To make one of the straight lines curved, just stare for some time on the small rectangles until a list shows up. Go to Convert to Arc to start editing. Actually, when you draw a rectangle or a polygon, you are drawing a polyline. The only difference is that the software helps you drawing them with equal sides and angles. You may not be able to move a polyline simply, since it doesn't have any central point. Just select the whole polyline and click on Move in Modify section. Then just click on one point and move where you like. If you want to decompose your polyline or polygon into its simple pieces of objects, use the Explode command. You will be able to manage the single lines or arcs one by one. When you work with 2D projects or maps, it is very common to put parallel lines at a defined distance from a point or an object. This is called offset. Click on the offset button. First of all, set such distance. You can enter directly the value, or you can get such by selecting two different points on your workspace. After pressing enter, you will have to select which object to put an offset. Once made it, you will add a parallel line at the distance set. This does work with polylines as well. A new object will be added at such distance kept constant, and such will be the same kind of the object selected. If you selected an arc, you will create a parallel arc, and so if you work with a polygon. Let's now see how to fill objects inside. Below the ellipse command, you will find the edge command. Click on such icon. This will open a window called Edge Creation or Editor, and it is right used to fill in objects. When you are adding an edge pattern, you can add such just to a single object, or you can add it to an enclosed area made by different objects, even belonging to different layers. You have two ways to add edge patterns. If you choose pick points, the edge will be added on the enclosed area that AutoCAD finds when you click on one point in the workspace. This area can be made by a single object, different objects on the same layer, or different objects on different layers. The edge is created when you do have an area enclosed. Otherwise, you can choose Select. This requires not an enclosed area, but objects selected that create together the enclosed area to fill with a pattern. The edge will be not created until an enclosed space is revealed with the points selected. If you are right adding an edge pattern, keep in mind that the filling stops at the first boundary mat. If you want to expand the filling, you have to click over these boundaries. In case you mistake in putting any pattern, just use the command line to undo the latest filling. Press U from your keyboard and then press Enter. This will make you repeat the last step. Notice that if you fill more objects with one single command, you will create a single edge only. If you want to create edge patterns separately, you have to fill each object with a single command. So for each one of them, you have to fill in, then press the Escape button from your keyboard, and then go again to the Edge button and repeat the process. Edge patterns just created are recognized through a rounded point on the center. Through that point, you will move the pattern out of the objects of origin. Be careful because you can't put the pattern again on objects easily, unless you repeat the Edge command. When you move the pattern put, this becomes an object aside that you can edit like a polygon or a polyline. As long as the edge stays centered in the object, any editing applied to the object boundaries will be applied to the edge as well. Whenever you need the edge creation window, just select a pattern you already made. It will automatically appear. On the Boundaries section, you can remove these patterns too. Go to Remove and select the objects that do create the enclosed area. It's needed just one side missing in the area to remove the wall edge. If you select the boundaries of a pattern aside, this will be directly removed. Patterns can be modified in many ways. Select the pattern from the Pattern section and use the Properties one to edit further. You can add transparency, change direction and sides of patterns and color. Go to the first option on top and left to choose to put a gradient instead of a pattern and choose the two colors. If you want to further edit your edge, go to option on the right where you can see a small black arrow. This opens the window where you can fully edit your edge or gradient. Very important, especially in more complex projects, are the properties and the layers. For each object, you can select a color to recognize it better. In Properties section, you can further change objects, such as thickness of lines and kind of line. Properties marked with by layer mean that the object is taking the same default properties of the layer it belongs to. Each layer has its own name and color, and each object does belong to one and just one of the list of layers you have, that you can check by selecting a point and staring at it for some time. Layers are very important to work better with your project. When it is complex, you may be in distress because of too many lines and objects communicating each other or too much close. You may need to hide all objects you don't need temporarily while making an action or drawing and then show again the previous objects hidden when finishing. Let's suppose to hide these objects in red color. Click on Layer section and go to Copy Objects to New Layer. Select the objects interested and then press N and then Enter key following your command line to create a new layer. In the new window, digit the name of your new layer and then click on OK, and then X to finish the process. If you check, you will have two copies of the same object, one belonging to the older layer and the one to the newer one. If you don't need the first object, just delete it to keep the object into the new layer only. You can see this effect also in the third space in the section Layers, next to the colored small square. By clicking on it, you can further check the full list of layers you actually have. And the 01 is the one you have by default. In case you want to add new objects to your newest layer, just select them and click on the slot before. Then choose in the list the layer with the name of the newest one. In this case, you won't have any extra copy, since you are just moving an object between two layers. You can see in such list 4 different icons. The last one simply says the main color of the layer, which is called the bilayer color, and next to it its name. The first icon is used to hide or show all the objects related to the layer considered. Hiding all objects of a layer will make them invisible, so you can edit, move or see them either. Last important one is the lock icon. This simply blocks all the objects belonging to such layer, so that you can see them, but you can actually edit or move them in any way. Use lock or the first icon depending on what you actually need to see and to do. Well, that's all you need to make your 2D design projects. If you want to get into 3D project designs, follow us in our next video. Thanks for watching.